everyone, welcome to today's lesson. Welkom by vandagse klas. Ek gaan vandag met julle bespreek betower, bedryf 2. Baie welkom. Ek sien nog 'n persoon het ons gejoin. Betower bedryf 2. Don't mind my speaker here. I hope on everybody's screen is bedryf 2. Tweede bedryf. Can somebody just maybe send me a message to let me know if you all can see it? All right, I'm going to assume that everyone can see this. Ek gaan vir jou lees. En terwyl ek lees, moet jy asseblief vir my volg. Yes, okay, almal kan sien. Great. Ek gaan lees, volg asseblief saam met my. So I'm going to read, translate and explain. So today's lesson will work a bit differently than yesterday. Ek gaan lees en ek gaan verduidelik en ek gaan vertaal op dieselfde tyd. So we might not finish this whole chapter today, it's fine. Whatever I don't finish today, I'll finish on Monday. So you guys can let me know at the end of the lesson what time suits you, but I think on Monday again we'll have a lesson at 10:15. We'll have a lesson again. Alright, die tweede bedryf, en ek gaan begin hierso, speel af in die bos. Kan jy onthou gister, het ek gepraat oor neuwe teks. Nou hier die gedeelte in hakies, is die neuwe teks. Kan julle dit sien, die neuwe teks. Hierdie gedeelte se hakies is die neuwe teks. Dit speel af in die bos. Die bos is nou die milieu. Milieu, I told you yesterday, it's where something is taking place. En dit gee vir ons inligting. So die neuwe teks gee vir ons inligting oor wat? Die area of waar, waar hierdie toneel gaan afspeel. Dis in die bos en dan bietjie later by ouma se huis en by die skool. So ons het 3 milieu in hierdie deel van die drama in die tweede bedryf. Nadia sê vir die gehoor, remember, I don't know if you guys remember this from the class, but a gehoor is an audience. You guys are my audience. Die mense wat luister is die gehoor. Nadia sê vir die gehoor, so niemand anders kan dit hoor op die verhoog. Verhoog is the stage, nobody else can hear it. Sy praat met die gehoor. Ek volg Boonk se uitgetrapte skoenspore in die voetpaadjie wat deur die donsgras kronkel en tussen die bome inloop. She's following Boonk's path, a footpath that's going through the forest. All right. Maar, top of the page, maar 'n eind van die bos af gaan ek staan. Ek kyk hoe Boonk eers groen word, soos die blare, and I don't know if you can see this, but I wrote here camoufleur, which is camouflage. And she thinks he's starting to camouflage, he's turning green. He's not really turning green, he's just camouflaging. Eers groen word, soos die blare, en toe in 'n skadu verander en wegraak. He turned into a shadow and he disappeared. Sy is in gedagte, very deep in thought, en skielik haastig, she's in a hurry. Ek kan nie hier bly nie. Hier, meaning what? Die bos. Hier, die bos. Ek kan nie hier bly nie. Ek moet huis toe gaan. I have to go home. I see somebody is talking in a chat. The question. Okay, I can't. Somebody, you are talking very slow. I'm trying to speak very slow that everyone can understand me. Oratile, I see you can't hear me. Maybe it's because the mute is off on your side. Because my voice is on. Okay, I'm going to keep reading.
Just Audio's like, gedachte, she's deep in thought. You can start all the way to the left, which says something audio, ne?
Then you're gonna press it and like it's gonna show something like a pop-up notification. You just have to press on it. I know it looks like you can't press it, but you have to press on it. Then yeah, you'll start hearing afterwards. Okay, right. I deleted that shit, but right. Dude, basically you must swipe all the way to the left, né? And then press that round button, né? It's gonna show like a notification, like, and it looks like you can't press it. You can, then you have to like press allow, then yeah.
Okay, guys, I'm just gonna continue. All right. Ek moet huis toe gaan. She has to go home. She realizes what she's doing is wrong. Sy moenie in die bos wees nie. Sy weet sy doen iets verkeerd. Sy moenie alleen saam met 'n seun wees in die bos nie. Sy moet huis toe gaan. Sy sê, "Ouma sal wonder waar ek is." Remember, she stays with her granny. That's a big way her life changed. She not only moved to a new area, but she's also living with somebody new. We discussed that yesterday. Ouma sal wonder waar ek is. En my ma, wat nou nog nie gebel het nie. Her mother still hasn't called her yet. Sy sal nie daarvan hou as ek so agter seuns aan hardloop nie. My mom won't like it, me running after boys. And then comes something very, very important that you guys really need to take note of. She says, my ma, wat my met post-it notes op die yskas deur en geldnote vasdruk onder yskas magnete probeer groot maak het. I'm going to stop there. I'm going to explain that quickly. My mom, what with post-it notes on the fridge door and money with fridge magnets tried to raise me. Her mom tried to raise her by putting post-it notes and money on a fridge magnet on the fridge. And we call that a yskas kind. A yskas kind. You'll see here, I'm indicating it now with the mouse. Yskas kind. In die toets gaan ek vir jou vra, wat is 'n yskas kind? Dan gaan jy sê, dis iemand wat sy ma kommunikeer met post-it notes of briefies op die yskas en geld op die yskas met magnete. Alright, I made a note of it. I will give it to you guys. I'm sure Ms. Lou also shared the notes that I created with you as well. I'll go through them a bit later. And then here in purple. Eindelijk, actually, is die goed wat met my en daar die ou in Johannesburg gebeur het, my ma se skuld. Sy sê, the stuff that happened in Joburg, it's my mom's fault. Now, my opinion, why she thinks this is her mom's fault, hoekom dink sy, dis haar ma se skuld? Want haar ma spandeer nie baie tyd met haar nie. Haar ma werk die heel tyd. Sy spandeer nie baie tyd met haar kind nie. Maar dit was die ou Armand, I'm reading. Maar dit was die ou Armand wat gesê het, hy het my lief en nie my ma nie. En kyk nou, kyk wat het gebeur met ma se yskas kind. She saying her mom never said she loved her. Never. It was the boy, Armand, in Joburg, that said, I love you. Joy sê vir die gehoor. Remember, I told you, Joy is een van die vertellers in die verhaal. Joy sê vir die gehoor. Nadia sê dit vir die klippe, langs die pad, maar sy weet nie of die klippe luister nie. Nadia is talking to the rocks along the road, and it seemed maybe like, oh, that is a bit crazy. But remember, not everything in this book is the reality. Okay, it's a bit like a fairy tale as well. And she's saying, oh, she's just talking to the rocks. She doesn't know if anyone's really listening to her. En dan sê Punk, vir Joy en die gehoor. Die klippe luister, die bome ook en die wind. Die klippe en die bome, it's referring to things in nature, klippe, the rocks or the stones, in the boomer, the trees, in the wind, the wind. It means somebody is always caring. Somebody always cares. Nadia sê vir die gehoor en as binnenspraak. Dalk bly Punk nie in die bos nie. Maybe he does not live in the forest, dink ek daar die aand. Dalk het hy net daar gaan loop. En het hy rarig groen geword? Did he really turn green toe hy die bos binnenstap? Nee. Dit was die bome wat hom ingekleer het. Now, that's what I said earlier, now he just camouflaged. Joy sê vir die gehoor, by die huis gaan lê Nadia op haar ouma se groot rusbank op die stoep en huiswerk doen. Dis toe dat dit gebeur. Nadia is lying on the couch and then something happened. Look here in brackets, please. Die fluit van 'n voël klink twee keer op. A bird, we hear a bird on the stage. Eers sag en dan harder. Nadia kom reg op. She sits up straight en kyk in die bos se rigting. Groen ligte glim nader aan haar. She sees green lights coming towards her. Die lig word helderder. Helderder, brighter. Wanneer dit sekelwit, just gonna go to the next page. Wanneer dit sekelwit is, sekelwit meaning this green light turned white, tree Punk die lig droomagtig binne. It's like in a dream he's coming to her. First with a green light that became white. And that symbolizes to us a fairy tale. Or not a fairy tale, but something magical happening that this is not really real. Dit symboliseer iets magies. Magies is an important word. Magies, something magical. Iets magies, iets wat nie rarig gebeur nie. Dis in 'n droom. Hy is heeltemal in wit geklee. He has white clothes on. En hy glimlag vir haar en hou sy hand na haar uit. Punk droomagtig. Punk droomagtig, he's speaking like, he's not speaking, but it's like a dream. Maar 'n vooraf opgeneemde bandopname speel die woorde. So he's not talking on stage, but there's a pre-recorded tape that he's playing. Remember, this is a play. So, sorry, that was my phone. Remember, this is a play. So, it's something on stage, so they pre-recorded his words. Ek gaan vir jou 'n sprookie vertel, Nadia. Eendag was daar. I'm going to tell you a fairy tale. One day, there was. ... And then it stopped. The lights go down. Joy sê vir die gehoor. Daardie Vrydagoggend in die Engelse klas sien Nadia vir Punk met 'n notstringboomblaartjie in sy hare. Sy vaal hemp is gedoop in die son. This, a blaartjie, she sees him in the English class. He has some sort of leaf in his hair. Because I think we all know he might live in the forest. Alright. Sy vaal hemp is gedoop in die son. Vaal, meaning it is faded. His shirt, why would his shirt be faded? It's maybe very old, he doesn't have money to buy a new shirt, or he has washed the shirt so many times that it's faded already. Nadia sê vir haarself, was dit wat ek in ouma se tuin gesien het waar? Was my dream really real? Wat as dit was? Wie is Punk? Nee, yes, ek moet ophou aan hom dink. Ek moet ophou om sy naam in my huiswerkboek te skryf en dit dan later uit te vee. Net nou sien iemand dit, voor ek dit kan uitvee. She's saying now, I must stop writing his name in my homework diary and erasing it. What if somebody sees it? So, sy is 'n bietjie skaam. She's also a bit shy and a bit embarrassed. Maybe she likes him a little bit. Maar sy wil nie hê dat iemand moet weet dat sy eintlik van hom hou nie. Die klok lui, the bell is ringing, en Jervin staan reg agter Punk. Jervin is standing behind Punk, en sy skouer, his shoulder, druk teen Punk sin. He's pushing him with his shoulder. Daar's iets aggressiefs. He's very aggressive tartend, teasing aan sy houding. Hy fluister, fluister is to whisper. Hy fluister iets in Punk se oor. En Punk laat sak sy kop. Jervin whispers something in Punk's ear, obviously something very mean. En hy, Punk laat sak sy kop. He's bow his head down. Obviously he said something really bad to him. En dan loop Jervin weg. He obviously is walking away. Punk kyk hom bang agterna and he looks towards Jervin's side where he was walking and he looks a bit scared. Nadia sien dit en sy frons. Frons is frown. I don't know if you can see it, but I'm frowning. Frons is to frown. Okay. Punk lig sy kop en draai dit bos toe. He looks toward the forest. Toe maar klippe, toe maar bome, toe maar wind. Ek is okay. He's saying, don't worry, I'm all right. Because he says, in nature, there's always, or in life, there's always somebody that is listening and that is worried about you. But now he's saying, it's all right. Ek is okay. Nadia sê vir die gehoor, by die huis is my ouma opgewonde, excited. Sy sê, my ma het gebel. Sy kom môre kuier. Môre is Saterdag. 'N hele dag om saam met my ma te wees. Maar Saterdag kom. Dot, dot, dot. And that dot, dot, dot indicate to us time that passes. I wrote here, tydsverloop. It means time that has passed. So, a possible question is, hoe weet ons Nadia het lank gewag? Dan kan jy vir my sê die ellips, die tydsverloop aan. En sy sit die hele dag en wag vir my ma op die stoep. Die son skuif verby die Kersrose, oor die trappe, die petunias, die akkerboom, oor die heining en af met die straat. My ma kom nie. My ma kom nie. All this indicate to us time. She's saying the sun moves away. She's saying over this type of roses, over the flowers, over the trees, she can see the sun going down, down, down. So it indicates to us also that time has passed. Daar is baie tyd wat verby gegaan het. My ma kom nie. Ek dink Nadia is 'n bietjie ontsteld. I honestly think she's a little bit upset. Ek sou ook baie ontsteld gewees het, want my ouma het gesê sy kom kuier. Die ma het gebel en gesê sy kom kuier. So, my opinion, and I don't know if this is right, but my opinion is that I think the granny maybe called the mother and said, please come visit. I do not think it was the mother at all that said she's going to come visit. I see somebody's asking about page numbers. Is it not on the board? Can somebody just tell me if page 32 is on the screen, not the board, sorry. Okay, I'm just going to continue reading. I assume everyone can see it. All right. Top of page 33. Nou is ons in die bos, in the forest. Nadia sê vir die gehoor. Okay, we can see it clearly. Alright, thank you. Thank you, Toho. Dan van 'n merwe. Okay. Nadia is in die bos en sy sê vir die gehoor. Die bitterheid lê swaar binne in my. She's very bitter. Sy's baie kwaad nou. Want haar maat nie kom kuier nie. Die bitterheid lê swaar in my toe ek alleen bos toe stap. Ek kry die voetpad waar fyn klippies soos broodkrummels gestrooi lê. She's feeling very bitter and she's walking towards the forest. And she finds a footpath again and she sees little tiny tiny little rocks or little pebbles and it is reminding her of breadcrumbs. Now, this is a reference to a fairy tale. It's referring to Hansel and Gretel. In Afrikaans, it's called Hansie en Griekie. Hansie en Griekie, Hansel en Gretel, dis breadcrumbs. Die bome maak die hemel bokant my soos 'n reuse hand toe. The trees is covering the heavens completely. She's saying it looks like a big hand that is covering everything, all these trees. So you can't really see the sky, you only see trees. Die skielike koelte kom vat aan my vel. She's feeling it's a bit chilly. Sy kyk op en sy word bang. Ek moenie hier wees nie. She realizes again, she's doing something wrong. She shouldn't be in the forest. She shouldn't be alone with a boy. She's doing something wrong. Ek het vir ouma gejok en gesê ek gaan by Joy kuier. Ek moenie hier wees nie. Again, here in brackets, a big piece you see. Remember this stuff in brackets, what is called newe teks. Nadia kyk wild om haar rond en sy is nou nog banger. Sy begin terugloop van waar sy kom, maar sy stop daar skielik. She stops in her tracks. She's walking, but she stops in her tracks and she looks around. Daar's 'n ewige geritsel van blare. She hears the leaves. Bunk hardloop op. Hy sien haar nie. Hy maak 'n draai oor die verhoog. Bunk runs on stage, but he doesn't see her. And sy arms is oopgesprei. Oopgesprei, spread out. His arms are spread out. Sy hemp wapper agter hom. His shirt is like flapping in the wind. Klavier musiek en Bunk af. We hear piano music and Bunk goes off stage. Joy sê vir die gehoor. Nadia herken vir Bunk, maar hoe langer sy na sy oopgestrekte arms, hoe meer lyk hulle vir haar soos vlerke. She's saying she recognizes Bunk and the longer she's looking at Bunk's arms, it's starting to look like wings. En Bunk lyk soos 'n voël wat losbreek van die aarde en gewigloos tussen die bome deur sweef. Joy is saying that Bunk looks like a bird that has broken free from earth and weightless. He is flying around. He's not really flying. Yes, she is describing to us in the forest, Bunk is free. And this is something I'm definitely going to ask in the test. In die bos is Bunk vry, maar by die skool is hy ingeperk. Don't worry if you did not write that notes down now. I did send it to Miss Lowe and she sent it to you. So I'll be talking more about that notes again a bit later in the lesson. In die klas, Nadia as binnenspraak. Nadia is talking to herself. Binnen, inside, she's talking to herself. Die klas ryk vandag weer soos toebroodjies en warm gebroeide skoene. She's saying the class smelling like sandwiches and warm shoes and bags and books in stof, in seense sweet, in bordkruid. So, very typical of the second break, that smell that the class have. Bunk loop met 'n skreefie glas in sy hand. Bunk walks with a piece of glass in his hand. Hy draai dit tussen sy vingers. He moves it in between his fingers, the piece of glass. En daarna teen die lig, he holds it to the light. Dan sien hy Nadia. Hy kyk na haar en sy draai skuldig weg. Skuldig, guilty. Hy kyk na haar, he looks at her and she looks away. Nadia staan met die skoolboek in die hande. As binnenspraak. Weet hy, ek was in die bos, she's talking to herself. Does he know I was in the forest? Joy kom nader. Ken jy dan nog nie daardie goed nie? En sy gryp na die skoolboek. She's saying, don't you know this work by now? And she takes the book. Hoekom ken Nadia nie die werk nie? Hoekom ken sy nie haar skoolwerk nie? Sy het die hele dag vir haar ma gewag. En sy was bos toe, so sy het nie geleer nie. Hoekom het sy nie geleer nie? Sy het vir haar ma gewag en sy was bos toe. Nadia sê, ek het nie gister kans gekry om te leer nie. Ah, was jy dalk by 'n ou? Ah, were you with a boy? Nadia antwoord nie. En Joy Oscar, het jy al 'n boyfriend gehad? In Afrikaans, a boyfriend is a kerel. A kerel, K-E-R-E-L, with a copy on the first E, kerel. Boyfriend is a kerel. Please remember that word. Joy asks Nadia, ah, have you had a boyfriend? Nadia is ongemakkelijk. She's very uncomfortable. As if she's lying. Nee. Rarig nie. Ek dog dis net ek. Wat so a total cook is. She's saying she's a cook. She's a bit of a prude. Nadia is ongemaklik. Luister Joy, ek moet nou gaan. I really have to go. Waar na toe? Wag, ek kom saam. Dan sien ek self. Wait for me, I'll go with you. Nadia says, nee, nie vandag nie. Okay, maar moenie stout wees nie hoor. En as jy is, neem kiekies. Joy is saying... Oh, I thought I hear somebody speak, sorry. Okay, don't be naughty, but if you are, please take pictures. Kikies is fotos. Nadia se oë rek van skok. She's very shocked en sy loop weg. Why do you think she's maybe shocked? Maybe she's reminded of something that happened. Sy loop weg. Punk kom op die verhoog. Hy loop bang agteruit. Punk walks on stage, but walks back slowly again backwards. Jervin volg hom dreigend. Jervin follows him threatening. Hulle oë beweeg nie van mekaar af nie. Their eyes follow each other. Jervin gryp vir Punk aan sy hemp. He grabs him by his shirt. And hy stamp hom, he pushes him. Eendag Punk, eendag gaan ek jou vrek maak. One day, Punk, I'm going to kill you. Nadia sien dit, en sy lyk benoud. She's a bit scared. Maar sy help nie. She doesn't help. Nadia is bang, en sy sê vir die gehoor. Na pauze is Punk nie in die klas nie. Sy kyk na sy tas. Sy tas lê by sy lessenaar. Lessenaar is die table, nê? In mekaar, soos iemand wat keer vir sy lyf. After break, his bag is by his table, he's not in class, and his bag is on the floor, and it almost looks to her like somebody that is protecting their body. So I imagine this bag on the floor that it looks like it doesn't have much books in it. Die tas, ek moet dit gaan ingee by die skoolkantoor. She has to go give to the office. Kom jy, Nadia? Vra Joy. Gaan maar, ek wil nog eers. 'N lig val op Punk se lessenaar. Dit blink op Punk se glasskerf. He left his piece of glass on the table. En Nadia tel dit op. Sjoe! Sy laat val dit amper. Maar na 'n rukkie kan sy dit vashou. She picks it up again. Sy buk dan om die tas op te tel. She picks his bag up. Punk se hare is deurmekaar, messy hair. Sy hemp hang uit en is vuilerig. His shirt is out of his pants and it's a bit dirty, obviously because Jervin pushed him around. En sy, hy is effens verleë. Effens verleë means he's a bit shy, he's a bit embarrassed about how he looks possibly. Dis my tas. Jy kan dit maar vir my gee. Dis seker swaar. Askies, ek wou net. Is okay. Hy vat sy tas. Daar's 'n gespanne stilte tussen hulle. There's a very stressed silence between them. Hulle kyk in mekaar se oë. Dankie, Nadia. They look in each other's eyes. Thank you, Nadia. En Punk walks off. Nadia sê as binnespraak. She's talking to herself. Is jy okay, Punk? Is jy okay? And with that, it is the end of Bedryf 2. So I'm just going to close my documents here. All right. I hope you can see these pictures. I don't know if you can. Dis prentjies of hoërskool, ag hoërskool, ah, sorry man jylle. Dit is prentjies van Maguba's kloof. It's really, really beautiful. En hier is 'n prentjie van die stoep. This is where Nadia sat with her granny. Maybe not really, but I like to believe maybe this is where they sat. All right, and later on we're going to read about the waterfall as well in another chapter. All right, and down here is a map, but Miss Lowe sent this to you as well. So I'm just quickly going to revise these pictures. Wat het hierso gebeur? What happened here? Dit was toe meneer in die klas praat oor Pythagoras en Punk luister nie in die klas nie. Al wanneer Punk geluister het, is toe hy meneer praat oor Pythagoras en dat Pythagoras kon time travel, deur tyd en ruimte beweeg. En hierso droom, dagdroom Punk in die klas, hy luister nie. Toe Nadia in die klas kom, toe kyk hy nie eers vir haar nie. En Jervin het vir Punk gegooi met 'n opgevrommelde papier. Yeah. Jervin threw Punk with a piece of paper. En die penneblikkie. Punk het sy penneblikkie verloor en toe het Nadia dit vir hom weer teruggegee. En hierso is 'n polistireen bakkie. Want Punk kry kos. Please stop drawing on the screen. Whoever is drawing. Thank you. Punk kry kos by die skool. Hy is deel van die voedingsskema by die skool. Alright, that's what I wanted to discuss with you. I also have a mind map here, but our time is running out. So I'm going to end the meeting for now. So you have this already. I'm going to end the meeting. And we will continue with this discussion on Monday. Ek gaan maandag praat oor hierdie notas. Okay. There we back to the home screen. Okay. Maandag gaan ek weer praat oor hierdie notas. En ek wil hê julle moet asseblief die vrae gaan lees. The questions that Ms. Lowe have sent you. Please go read through them. If there's something you want me to discuss, I will do it on Monday at 10:15. After this meeting, I'll create a new meeting and I'll send the new link for Monday at 10:15. So thank you very much for joining. Baie dankie dat julle geluister het vir vandag. Ek hoop dit help. En maandag gaan ons 'n bietjie meer gesels oor alles wat gebeur het in bedryf 2. So, lekker naweek. Tot ziens.